Well, this is me.
I had a lovely time tonight. Thanks for dealing with that creep at the bar.
Yeah, he was a bit of a weirdo. What was he doing there?
Definitely didn't belong there.
If you wanna, I've got some really nice Guatemalan slow-roasted coffee inside.
Coffee tastes like burnt cigarettes and petroleum-laced licorice. No thank you.
I'm not a huge fan of coffee.
How about a spot of tea? I've got Earl Grey, green tea, John Lemon, you name it.
Tea? That horrible, revolting leaf water that everyone pretends to like but no one actually does. Disgusting.
I guess I'm just not a huge fan of hot drinks in general.
You idiot. He doesn't want you to have a hot drink. He wants you to have a hot drink.
Actually, do you perchance have any other hot beverages?
I'm glad you asked.
What is it?
Bovril!
What the hell? You're in a living room with a man who drinks weak, watery gravy for pleasure.
It's so delicious. I could drink this all day.
If you like that, I've got some Bovril merchandise upstairs in my room.
Gee, that sounds pretty snazzy. Where did you get it from?
I know a man in Mogadishu. Some of the stuff's unopened scrumptiousness from the 70s.
40-year-old meat paste.
You silly sausage. The 1870s. The only 70s you'll hear Roger von Winkle talking about. It's John Lawson Johnston's original recipe. So, what do you reckon?
What are you waiting for? So what, he likes the meat water a little too much, but shag sister, and we can't keep masturbating to Dickinson's real deal.
Yeah, all right then.
Excellent news. Follow me upstairs. The gravy train is well and truly on the Bov rails. And this one was sent to the Allied forces way back in World War One.
Look, this is really fascinating and all, but you've got me here in your bedroom / nuclear apocalypse stockpile of beef stuff in your waterbed?
Not quite.
Jesus Christ.
Do you maybe want to join me?
Do you want to watch the documentary? It gets right into the etymology of the good stuff. They say that bov comes from the Latin for ox, and vril is a mysterious life force from a late 19th century novel, The Cow Force.
Enough pissing about. It's time to feel the dinkle of Roger von Winkle.
I want you, Roger. I want you to make me feel like a woman.
Sure thing, Missy. Why don't you say so earlier? I'm ready when you are.
Finally. But don't be too eager. I get quite bad dryness down there. Do you perchance have any lube?
Don't worry. I think I have a solution.